Hey everybody, Claude Diamond here, and the question came up, as you can see behind me, about the strategy of the first right of refusal. It's basically a right you negotiate or you sneak into a contract. I'm being very careful with my words here, where you first come, first serve is the way I like to say it. It's a contractual right to enter into a business transaction with a person or company before anyone else can. So say you find a deal. And you do a deal and you a regular sales agreement, you want a wholesale and an option agreement, and you sell the contract to somebody else, or you rent it or sublet it to somebody else, and they do not exercise their option, and you want to have the before it reverts to the owner, or you want to have the first shot to buy it. You weren't ready at one time, but now you are ready. You already made money on the transaction. This is a way to protect yourself. So you put that right of first refusal inside your agreement so that before they sell it to somebody else or list it, they have to contact you. I have some notes here I'm going to read you. I did a little homework, a little research on it. It's known as the first right of refusal. It's a contractual right that someone has to match or decline an offer made on a property. It's also a way to protect yourself. The person who holds this right is entitled to enter in a transaction before anyone else does. First come, first serve, like I said. If they decide not to enter in the transaction, then the seller or the person who is a holder of the contract at that time, they're free to entertain other offers. So it's a way to keep yourself in a deal. It's a way to negotiate with somebody who's not ready to do business. And you say, hey, why don't we do a first right of refusal? I can save you a lot of time, a lot of money. Why don't you contact me before you're ready to make the first offer or first sale to anybody else? Okay. This is a popular clause among those who do real estate or rent real estate. It gives them a first chance at a property. So say you're an investor, you negotiate to rent a property and then sublet it. And the owner says, I don't want to sell it for a couple of years. Well, in your agreement, put that first right of refusal so that you have the first shot to buy that property when they're ready to list it. And you can pre-negotiate the terms. I have the agreement or the verbiage behind me here. If you'd like, go to the link inside this video and just go there and I'll send you that link and we can talk for 15 minutes and I can really go into detail on how to utilize this strategy to protect yourself in so many different ways when the property owner is not ready to sell it or you want to purchase something in the future. And it's just a great little strategy. Not a lot of people know about it. And it takes guts to rule the world. And this is the knowledge you need to know. So click on the link, schedule with me. I'll get you the free outline and paperwork and contract. And then you can ask me a bunch of questions on how to do this properly, okay? Because as I always say, no one deserves success more than you. Bye-bye.